In my opinion, laser angle, it's not natural. Hello, my name is Stan and I'm a natural bodybuilder. I've been training for 26 years now as of the date of this video. So I know things or two about how we can gain muscles naturally, how much, and this is exactly what we're gonna be talking about today. Let's get started. In contrast, we will take some of the videos of Coach Greg and More Plates, More Dates, just to be more objective about what we are talking about. But keep in mind that as somebody that competed naturally in 2015, I know things or two about these things. Also, I am a Bulgarian. I know the tricks of the trade. So stick around. Let's find out together what I think about Lazar Angelov, why I think he's not natural, but most importantly, what we can learn from this story and what we can expect to gain really naturally. My intention with this video, it's not to be entertaining for you per se. Of course, I want to enjoy it, have a good time, but I also want you to take some valuable lessons that we can all learn from Lazar and from his experience with not recovering enough, with a lot of training, and also with his success. This video is gonna be different, and here is why. I'm a natural bodybuilder all my life. For 26 years, I've been trying. I was obsessed with gaining muscles, building strength, and all of these things. Something more. We are both Bulgarians with Lazar. We were both basketball players. We were exactly the same height, 180 centimeters or 5'10". But interestingly, in his peak, he was weighing 85 kilograms, when in my peak, in 2015, when I'm on stage, I'm 80 kilograms. Let me say this again. Lazar Angelov was 5 kilograms heavier than me in my best shape. As you can see here on the pictures, there is obvious difference in this. So you tell me, how this additional 5 kilograms of pure muscle fibers was achieved? Do you think that Lazar was training heavier than me? He was more obsessed than me? He was going more repetition after failure? He was taking some more powerful creatine or maybe better quality protein? Do you think this is the reason? Because I don't think so. What I think is happening, it's one possibility that Lazar is, as Coach Greg mentioned in his oldest video, it's total outlier. He is like literally one in a million, which is possible. That's why I said, I don't think so. Because I spent almost 3 decades trying to achieve that. And I'm still 5 kilograms lighter. Think about that. But when you look at the photos, specifically the shoulders area, you can see how my shoulders, they still have some weight, but there is not this three-dimensionality, there is nothing going up. Because when you look in this two-dimensional space, that is the photograph or the video material, even the computer games, you really get misled. I mean, how the objects appear in the frame. But even then, it's obvious that his physique has something more above mine. Even if, in my opinion, my legs are actually big. In addition, I want to also show you video, Jeff Nipper's video from like a year ago with Samuel Okolda, if I'm not mistaken. He's an Afro-American dude, he's really big, and really in photos he looks like he's not natural. But in this video specifically, and looking at his shoulders, I really think this guy is natural. So even comparing one of the best natural bodybuilders in the world right now, tested bodybuilders, compared to Lazar, the shoulders are still lacking. And why this emphasis on the shoulders? Because as we all know, most of the androgen receptors are here in the shoulder girdle, in the traps, the neck, upper part of the chest. That's why everybody thinks Lazar is not natural, but it's not why I think he was not natural at his peak. It's because we have the same age, same heritage, we start with the same place, we are Bulgarians. I mean, some of our predecessors was with these genes, so it's not that much of a difference. I know it's also speculation. It's possible that I am totally mistaken. And again, that's what I'm saying. This is purely my opinion. Only Lazar and he only will know the actual truth. We asked him, Tanya Nikola asked him in the podcast, and this is what he said.
Steroids. So what was your thought process behind this?
I'm going to tell you exactly. Because at that point, I've reached the physique that I want and the size that I want without steroids. You know, I was taking clenbuterol, which is not steroid.
I was natural. So you can take it or not. But to make this video really valuable, I think we have to take something different in consideration. And this is the moment when Lazar was really at the peak of his fame, muscularity, and following and everything. Not that he don't have the following now, but you know what I'm talking about. 2014, 15, 16, when he was making this success really happen. At that point in time, I did not really like him, or he was not inspiring me, because I thought he's just misleading the young generation. He's taking these drugs and now all the postures and this in the mirror, just taking good photos, and he's misleading all these dudes, thinking that they can be like him. But we all know that this is not the case. For that reason, I wasn't really a fan. But after I saw this...
Maybe I want to say that... many people probably... I misled many people, especially from the younger generation, mm-hmm. because I see them, you know, me and some other people, we started this aesthetic thing, movement, and most of the followers were just kids, you know, like teenagers, like 14 years old, 15 years old. And for them to get this body at this age, the only way was to take steroids. So this wasn't the thing that I wanted, you know.
And as you can see, he confessed that he's realizing really that he misled so many 14 and 15 and 16 years old kids to take steroids. But now he realizes that. So this transition between Lazar before, just doing the money, doing the success, doing the work, but misleading, and what I'm seeing right now, it makes me do this video right now. Because I really like the change that happened with him. Up front, I'm saying I don't know him personally, even if we are Bulgarians, we know each other, I'm pretty certain. Lazar, if you are watching this video, hi. When I saw what happened with him after he lost his ability to train, his muscles, you know, his popularity in a way, because so many new guys coming. And you can see how really grew as a person, as a human being. He lost all of his muscles just to grow. And that's a great point, because Arnold Schwarzenegger did the same thing. He was also taking steroids and make everybody in the world taking it. Then the other guys show up, they did the same with the bodybuilding world. So the fitness models like Lazar, like Simeon Panda, Yekusilis, all the natural bodybuilders, did the same with our generation, and actually a little bit younger generation than us. And now when Lazar is out, I think he really can change everything by changing the message. Now knowing that, he can really make valuable experience available to his following and to everybody around the world. Now he can afford to be honest, like totally transparent. I don't really know why he will lie if it's a confession, but just my eyes can believe him when he's saying that he was natural. This 5 kilograms, this 10 pounds. Guys, I'm squatting 200 kilograms. This March, I was squatting 200 kilograms. 140 kilograms bench press. All right, I'm lying. 135. Bench press, 100 kilograms overhead press. I mean, I'm also very strong, you know, for the most of the population. And as I said, almost 30 years of training. This is what does not make any sense to me. But maybe it's a jealousy. He is widely more successful. He was widely more good looking and all of this stuff. So I take this in consideration too. And I wanted to make this discussion in English, not because something else, but because looking at this video right now, looking at me and my photos compared to Lazar one, the Lazar's photos, you can really compare and see what's the difference between taking and not taking. And if Lazar was real, so yeah, great, you can be even like in this good of a shape. If you can't, you can expect to gain something like mine kind of size, which I think is pretty satisfactory for most of you, the young guys that watching 14, 15 and above years old. For this reason, I don't wanted to blame him that he is lying or not lying, only he knows how it is. I just wanted to put new spin, because I never saw somebody like me with 30 years natural bodybuilding experience talking about the topic. I saw Coach Greg, I saw more plates, more dates, but they are looking from the different perspective. Even Lazar in his video said, when you are big and taking the steroids, the way you see people is very different. So the way I see, it's from the position of my experience, my muscles, but not through the lens of the steroids. So with all the muscles and exogenous testosterone that I have in the body. That's why I think every one of you that see this video, now you have this opinion too. That is actually natural bodybuilding. Here is the time for my personal message to Lazar. Lazar, hi, again. I want to tell you that after I saw your appearance in the podcast and after I saw how you really changed your wisdom that you've gained from the moment that you lost all of the muscles and really the life the way you know it really inspires me. And I think from now on, you will be widely more successful, widely more helpful. And it was something that you have to go through. And you are still one of the people that really make the history in regards to fitness modeling. So I want to wish you all the best. Nothing wrong with me not believing in you. If someday we have chance to meet each other, I will give you a chance to prove me wrong. But as I said, this is not the important thing here. The important thing is that you come up, you share your experience, and it's up to us to believe you. And it's up to you if you're telling us the truth. For all people watching right now, what we can all learn from this? And I'll tell you, Bulgaria is a very small country. And the thing that Lazar did with or without steroids, it's very big deal. Because a lot of people are taking steroids, but not everybody. It's a fitness icon, or Arnold Schwarzenegger. The training and the diet and everything that you have to do, you have to do. But if you want the luck, the timing, and everything that comes with it, you have to be ready all the time. What you can learn is the Lazar's mistake that he shared with us, but also his open-mindedness, how young guy from Bulgaria can think out of the box of this small country, because it's really small and it's not easy. Most of the people in Bulgaria don't think like that and actually achieve worldwide success, because this is not Coach Greg in Canada, more plates, more dates, I think he's in England or something. This is from Bulgaria, so doesn't matter where you are in the world. You can be in India, you can be in England, you can be in Congo, you can be in Bulgaria, in Serbia, in Romania. If you understand these words, if you see the Lazar's example, I think the real inspiration is how broad, how open-minded his thinking was about what's possible and how he can compete, even with natural or not natural, at the top. This is for all of us to take in consideration. And this is what we can take all from Lazar's story. We can be more open-minded. We should not limit ourselves in our beliefs, in our dreams, and what is really possible. Then maybe, just maybe, for all of us, his story, it will be driver for our ultimate success. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.